Hey everyone, it's Blue Lizard Jello, and welcome back to another episode of Everything Different in New Game Plus here in Dark Souls 2, and today we have quite a few areas to take care of. First things first, you will notice that I'm actually dual wielding and power stancing a pair of katanas. One of the viewers had asked if I would actually use power stance in one of the videos, so here you are. I hope you enjoy. I do switch out about halfway through because, well, they just kept breaking too quickly. But let's move right along, and the first stop is going to be the Shaded Woods. So everyone's favorite, the Shaded Woods. Now, I do show that you can actually kill these enemies in here, even though they're a bit hard to see. Once you get their location and you hit them, their enemy health bar will actually remain for quite a while, just like the normal enemies will, which does make fighting them just a little bit easier. Don't get me wrong, it's still an absolute pain, but it can be done. However, in the woods, once we pick up this loot, which is the same as it is in New Game, if you follow the right-hand side, just follow right along the wall, there's going to be a corpse there with an item, and in New Game, you'd pick up a pair of Lloyd's Talismans. In New Game Plus, you also get Gower's Ring of Protection, which helps to negate some damage that you would take from backstabs and other critical hits from behind. However, keep in mind, it no longer completely nullifies that damage. It is no longer viable for the Ancient Dragon fight. In this wooden chest in New Game, you would pick up 10 Magic Bolts, and now in New Game Plus, we pick up 30. Next is actually a pretty significant change. This item back here was a Lifegem in New Game, and now we actually get a Divine Blessing. So, something that actually doesn't cost 300 souls from Malentia. Now, down in this little cave where we can also find Dark Diver, Grandal, and Ornifex, we picked up a single Twinkling Titanite in New Game, and now we actually get three of them. And now we're just going to go ahead and skip right along, because that's all the different items and enemies that are in the Shaded Ruins and the Shaded Woods. So we're going to move right along to taking out Scorpioness Najka. And of course I have Man Scorpion Tark in tow because I like him, personally. Is he useful? Kind of, for a meat shield. He doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but he is really good for getting her attention. Now, unfortunately, and I haven't actually confirmed this, but it seems that Miss Najka may actually have some resistance to dark attacks, so using Dark Weapon and a Dark Pine Resin may have not been my greatest idea to date. But that's okay, because she actually gave me a pretty decent fight. She gave me a lot of attacks that I could work with, and, well, Man Scorpion, he did his best. He got an E for effort. I mean, if this was a drawing that he did when he was younger, I would hang it on the fridge for a few days, maybe a couple weeks, you know, to make him feel really good about himself. Eventually, when he forgets about it, yes, I am going to throw it away, but I mean, give the guy a little bit of self-esteem. Now, I came over here when she went underground because I was hoping to actually have her destroy this tree so we could get that super special secret item that not too many people know about. Unfortunately, she decided to go after Man Scorpion Tark. Now, I have confirmed that that is still just a single flame butterfly, so don't worry, you're not missing anything by not getting that item in New Game Plus. I promise. Now, much like a lot of the other fights that we have in New Game Plus, the fight itself is the same, there's no adds or anything like that. However, we do get Najka's Soul, and in addition to that, we also get the Southern Ritual Band Plus 2. So if you don't want to put too many points into attunement, but you want those slots, the Southern Ritual Band Plus 2 will actually give you free 3 slots. Here we are on the Doors of Pharros, and in this corner right here, normally we had a pair of Amber Herbs, and now we actually have a pair of Wilted Dusk Herbs, so we got an upgrade. Further on in the Doors of Pharros, and if you don't know where this door is, go ahead and link this to my Everything Possible in Doors of Pharros video, and it should give you an idea of where that Pharros Lockstone contraption is. But with this anvil on a chain-wielding Gurm guarding a chest, we do have a slight change in the item content. And I do mean slight. So normally in New Game, you come in here, you fight through that Gurm, you'll get 15 magic arrows. And well, now, after braving the poison, you actually get to double that number and pick up 30. Not even triple like it has been doing in New Game Plus. Sorry to say. Now it's time for another boss. Now normally, I would say that, oh, look at that bloodstain. It looks like someone must have left them here. I guess I should pick up their souls. But today, I'm just going to be honest and tell you that based on the bloodstain as well as my diminished health, That's my bloodstain. In fact, this is not the first time that I had to collect my bloodstain. I didn't show all those deaths because, well, I wanted to keep this video at a reasonable length and not waste too much of your time. And also because I was raging as I was fighting this boss. As a melee character, to be honest, I don't have very much strategy. I try to kill the small rats as quickly as I can. It just doesn't work out all that well typically, and I still have one trailing, as you can see, and it's still going to be here for another moment or two. So if any of you other melee characters have any suggestions, please feel free to let me know so I can stop dying to the Rat Authority over and over and over again. Finally, the smaller rat is dead. And with him done, I will go ahead and use Sunlight Blade to make this fight just a little bit quicker. Not that much quicker, as you can see. Still actually getting close enough that I was worried. But finally, I got another hit on him. Really felt like it had been a while at that point. Luckily, I got a critical strike there thanks to the engraved gauntlets. Love those gauntlets. Now, in this fight, using the R2 poke attack is really not the best idea. Trying to poke something with rather small hitboxes. By the way, if you didn't see that rat flying around in the background thanks to ragdoll physics, go ahead and watch that part again. It's one of the few times in Dark Souls 2 we get to marvel at that Havoc engine just flinging bodies around. However, I will forever be in love with that running R1 attack. And thanks to the rat vomit, I was able to take him out. Nothing changes with the fight, nothing changes with the drops, but I told you that I would show you all New Game Plus bosses, including the one that I apparently hate the most. I've actually just decided that. Moving right along to Brightstone Cove Tseldora in the Royal Camp. You may be pretty surprised when you show up into this area, only to find... well, it seems like the pig's parents have showed up. Now not only do we get the two normal pigs, but we get these rather large, very aggressive pigs as well. Now these are not to be confused with the very tiny, adorable pig that has a 1 in 1,000 chance of spawning to help you find the pickaxe. No, no, these are true New Game Plus, really bad, really mean piggies. Also, they have quite the set of hyper armor when it comes to their attacks, so be sure that when you're attacking, if you're attacking the same time they are, expect to do considerably less damage than your attacks would normally do. And I think there's an example of that. Now, I'm not sure what all that these pigs can drop, however, I do know that the two of these each dropped a Divine Blessing. So that may be 100% drop, not sure, but if you're looking to farm Divine Blessing because that is your hearing curative of choice, your healing curative may have just been a redundancy there, but that's okay. Then this may be the place to farm for you. And while it's not a very quick build up, just keep in mind that they do inflict bleed, and you really don't want to be out of stamina and walking slowly with these guys around. And you can see in the background, I only did 69 damage to the pig there, and another 83. That's because of his hyper armor that he had while attacking. There's 69 damage there again. There's that hyper armor. But finally, they have been slain, and we can continue looting in our pig free glory. And next we have, on the edge of this well, there's a corpse, and in new game, we got a single Titanite shard, and now we actually get 3 Titanite shards and 3 large Titanite shards. Pretty good trade-off. Now in this next section, you may have already seen this spoiled for you, but surprise, surprise, as you're entering the cathedral to go fight the, or right before fighting the prowling Magus, you can actually get a good glimpse of Freya, who does have a boss health bar. You can do damage. Now, you can do damage. That is not to say that I do damage. But keep in mind, any damage you do now will carry over into the actual boss fight. Now, I haven't seen anyone able to kill her in this location, but if it's been done, please let me know. If there's a video out there, I would love to see it. So if it exists, please point it out to me so I can take a look. Now, in this room, as I pathetically try to hit the spider out of that hole, of course we have this famous audible trap, but I have Benny in tow, so I'm not too worried. Let's go ahead and clear these spiders very quickly. And then inside the chest, in new game, we got 20 heavy bolts, and now we get 20 magic bolts. And a great sight, but that's from the spiders, and completely irrelevant. Now through this door, everyone knows about the illusory wall straight ahead. You open up the illusory wall, you run up the stairs, and you get yourself a free Estus Flash Shard. But now, it's not so free, because now we do actually have the same type of caster that you fight in the boss fight ahead is now actually guarding the Estus Flash Shard. Fortunately, they're very weak. Unfortunately for me, I decided to roll through that jar which contains water, which lowers my lightning defense. Going against a couple of enemies who spam lightning spheres, maybe that was a poor decision. We'll have to wait and see. Who am I kidding? It's still the Prowling Magus. It's still a very easy boss fight. And yes, I know people have died to the Prowling Magus, and I don't know, maybe I have before. I doubt it, but maybe. And it's nothing I'll ever admit to anyway. But it's still the same old boss fight. Take out the casters, and then you can focus on the actual Magus himself. And then if you can't take out the congregation, then it's time to unplug your controller or your keyboard or however it is you play this game. And just stick to Hello Kitty Island Adventure. Is that cliche to say? I think that's cliche. I don't even know if that's a real game. I think I'm just quoting it from South Park at this point. But that is the Prowling Magus and Congregation. Big thanks to my friend Benny here. We'll see him again later on. Okay, just a few more changes here. We are nearing the Duke's Deer Freya boss fight, and on the opposite side of this phantom is where the pickaxe-wielding peasant resides. However, this is a New Game Plus only Black Phantom, who is pretty quick. However, he is wearing light armor and is basically poisonless, so as long as you can spam your attacks, you'll be just fine. Especially if you will shamefully just spam R2, 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 R2. Next, in the actual area right before the boss arena, we have this item hiding behind the pillar. And earlier in the game, in new game, we would get a Twilight Herb, and now we have 3 Wilted Dusk Herbs. And that is actually going to do it as far as all of the new enemies and the new items are concerned, with the exception of what we're going to get from killing Freya here. But now, of course, we've summoned Ashen Knight Void, and we will kill this spider once and for all. Now, there is a little bit of damage taken off of her health bar. If you're paying attention, you'll notice I didn't do that damage. That was all my friend Benny. So, big props to Ben Heart of Jugo for actually helping me out with this boss fight, even though he's not summonable. Now, unfortunately, Ashen Knight Boyd, you're going to see in just a moment here. Well, Ashen Knight Boyd decides to actually start attacking Freya's body, and not the head. So not only does he not do a great job of actually doing much damage to Freya, well, unfortunately, he also loses aggro pretty quickly, and then I'm left with webs, I'm left with lasers, I'm left with a lot of foot stomping, and overall just a bad time. In fact, eventually Freya gets into this looping animation of her just stomping and spitting poison. Well, bad times were had by all. Now, a fun little aside, something that I've never done and something that honestly I'll never do. If you come into this fight and you have warmth equipped, it is actually possible to cut off both of Freya's heads and not kill her. The method would be to break off one head, cast warmth near the center of her body, and let that heal her for as much as it can. You might need to heal it more than once, and then you go to the opposite side and you can break off that head. If you do it correctly, you can successfully decapitate both sides and still have some health remaining, and all she'll do is flail around and stomp, and well, she becomes completely unkillable and you'll have to either homeward bone or Age Feather out of there and start over. If you want to try it and play some soccer with the two heads, by all means, it's really just not my bag. Normally, Ashen Knight Boyd does a phenomenal job tanking this fight and, well, right now doing a great job clearing the ads, but unfortunately, we are about to say goodbye to our dear friend. But that's okay. Ashen Knight Boyd, you will be remembered, maybe not for this fight so much, but in all the other fights prior, where you actually were useful. I salute you. And with this last laser attack, we can deliver the killing blow, taking out the Duke's dear Freya, picking up her soul in the meantime, as well as picking up the old Pale Drake soul. And for those of you who may not be too familiar with Dark Souls 1 and its lore, that would be a very strong and obvious reference to Seath the Scaleless, the dragon who helped to actually take out the ancient dragons in Dark Souls 1 lore. Never forget to pick up the Soul of the Great One that's laying on the ground there underneath the dragon. Because remember, Freya is not a Great One. Freya is simply guarding the body of the dragon, who is the Great One. Whether or not you believe that's Seath or not, that's totally up to you. Personally, I don't think that corpse is Seath. But that's my two cents. Everything here is the same, I'm just showing you the rest of the area so we can get to the Primal Bonfire. And that's going to wrap up the episode. But of course, everyone's favorite decapitated enemy in this game, the body of Vengarl. You know, it's funny, some enemies just have unlimited poise, and even though he's wearing some pretty decent armor, he's kind of a pushover as far as poise goes. It's a shame. I mean, he seems like a really nice guy, just really getting the shaft as far as poise goes. But at any rate, that is going to wrap it up. So we have taken care of the Shaded Woods, Shaded Ruins, the Doors of Pharros, and Brightstone Cove Tseldora in New Game Plus, and pointed out all the differences. I hope you learned something. If you did, leave me a comment below. If I missed something, you gotta let me know that too. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will catch you next time.